Try to solve this problem.
Swastik Mishra, please don't keep on writing 2 2 2 2. Swastik Mishra, how many times have you written 2? Please do not misuse the chat box. Just write once in the chat box and come back to the screen. Just don't keep on studying the chat box over and over again. You will be given a chance to talk when the man is completed with the lesson. Man will ask you to mute and unmute, and you will be given a turn to speak and give your
C and D.
So please be
recommended. It's
a very, very easy lesson to do.
Radius is 2, so it is greater than 2. And the angle is between pi by 4 and the angle is between z minus z naught.
Sir, is the answer B?
What is z plus 1, argument of z plus 1.
Okay.
This region is radius greater than 2, right?
Yes, sir, I got it.
This distance is 2 from this one. Right? So this region is radius greater than 2. Okay. And this radius is from the point minus 1. So the z minus z naught is greater than 2. So it is z minus z naught is z plus 1. This is circle with center as minus 1.
Very good.
Very good. They are
answering very
well. Z minus z naught equal to r. If this is a circle, center at z naught. Okay, so z plus 1 greater than 2 is a region outside the circle of radius 2, but the center is at minus 1, and this is minus 1. Okay,
yes, sir.
And the argument of z plus 1, so argument of this line is z minus z naught. You take any point, mark it as z, so this line is z minus z naught, that is z plus 1. Okay. The argument lies between minus pi by 4 and plus pi by 4. C and D are eliminated because the radius is less than 2, because this region is greater than 2. So C and D are gone. This region is z minus z naught, z minus minus 1. So this is z plus 1 greater than 2, and the angle is z plus 1. Lying between minus 5 and plus 5. Okay, get used to these things. This one. This you have to do this operation. C1 plus C2 plus C3. And push it to C1. You know this column operation, right?
So, no, sir.
Accept this thing right now. This is column 1. This is column 2. This is column 3. Okay. So what you have to do is have to add column 1, 2, 3 and put it in column 1. Okay.
Okay.
This column operation which will leave the math, the value of this determinant unchanged.
Okay.
Do that one, you will get. Z, Z, Z. Because 1 plus omega square is how much? This is equal to how much? Omega is cube root, right? So 1 plus omega plus omega is how much? You are not revising. This is 1. This is omega. This is omega square. Okay. So these are like 3 vectors uniformly displaced. So the sum is 0. Okay. So the first column becomes z, z, z because 1 plus omega plus omega square is 0. That will go away. Right. I have omega z plus omega square 1. Right. And then I can take z outside. It will become 1, 1, 1. I can take a factor common outside from a column. Okay, this is also determined property.
Yes. Please don't be writing in chat now because we are taking your gestures and we will also unmute you whenever needed. Okay, so don't keep on writing in chat all the time. You will be told when to write in the chat box.
Okay, you can take a factor commonly out of the column. So Z is coming out, not like this, just one number. Okay, now now I can do this operation of R2 minus R1 and R3 minus R1. I'll keep the first row like that. And if I subtract R2 minus R1, will be Z plus omega square minus omega, 1 minus omega square, and 0, 1 minus omega. And Z plus omega minus omega square. Is this clear? R2 minus R1 and R3 minus R1. One of the rows I have to keep fixed and the other rows I can manipulate. In a sense, linear combination of other rows. Okay. Now I can expand this, open this determinant as Z into 1 into this one. 1 into this part. Other things will become zero because of these two. Okay, so this thing will simplify as Z into Z square.
Hey.
Okay, so this is equal to 0.
Need to pay, please sit up. Can you please sit up?
Which implies Z is 0. That is the only solution. Okay, so while simplifying this, you just have to use this property 1 plus omega square equal to 0. And what is omega cube? Omega cube is 1. Okay, so if you use these two, you can simplify this as Z square. Because if you multiply this thing, you get only omega cube powers of omega. Okay. And if you simplify this one, this is like this, you know how to simplify, right?
I was about to give you a sound that you might have been tired.
This minus this. Determinant AB CD equal to AD minus BC. Okay, use this result. Right, so the answer is 1. Is it clear? Can you hear me now?
Yes, sir. Now I can hear you.
Okay. So this is the first operation you're doing. Column 1 plus column 2 plus column 3 and put it in column 1. Okay. And the next one is R2 minus R1 and R3 minus R1. Okay. And then you have to simplify this as, and this is the, if you have 2 by 2 determinant, the value is AD minus BC. That you have to do. And you will get combination of omega powers, right? So you have to use these two quantities, these two results. One plus omega cube is 1, right?
Hello.
Yeah. So omega cube is 1. You know that, right?
Sorry.
Omega cube is 1. This one.
Omega cube is 1.
Because it's cube root. Is that, you know that, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if you use these two, you'll be able to simplify this one. Okay. This is second order determinant, 2 by 2 determinant. The value of this is AD minus BC. Accept this one. Okay.
Yes, sir.
And using that thing, you can simplify this this thing. Because this thing is 1 into this one. The rest of the things will be 0 because of these two zeros. So this is 2 by 2 determinant. So if you use this thing, you will simplify this thing and you can get z square. And while simplifying, you have these two results. Okay. So it will become z square. So z cube equal to 0. So the only value of z is 0. So the number of distinct z satisfying this one is 1. So the answer is 1.
Okay.
Here.
Okay, sir.
This one. So this thing is
yes.
Real, right? So what does it mean?
It is for math, correct.
There will be no I.
Yeah, but so that means that this plus its conjugate is real part.
Yeah.
No, one more thing is this complex number is same as its conjugate.
Hello?
You will start from here.
Should sit in a quieter place.
See, ma'am, screen.
Yes, sir.
If complex number ZE equal to ZE conjugate, the symptom is that. Is this clear?
Rishikesh Patil, please do not annotate.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that you have to use. So omega minus.
This is the last
warning.
Now you will be out of the class. If I see you writing any. Then
children,
please see these questions and let's
hello. Yes, sir.
This is related to this condition. It's purely real. That conjugate will get distributed. So conjugate of numerator denominator, I can take it separately, and then conjugate of the terms, and then conjugate of the product again can take it separately. Okay. So this I can, and mod z is not equal to 1. So this thing is not equal to 0. And this is also not equal to 0. Because mod of z is same as mod of z bar. Okay. So z not equal to 1 means z bar is also not equal to 1. So the denominators are not equal to 0, so you can cross multiply and simplify. Okay, do it. Yeah. No, you can simplify now, right? Cross multiply and
yeah.
Simplify. Yeah. And then you have to get this So it will come out to be.
So this is.
And we use the condition Z is not equal to 1, so this is the answer.
Children, if I am unmuting you, that does not mean you. If I am giving you permission to unmute yourself, that does not mean that you keep on unmuting yourself.
This step you have to get by doing some manifestation. This is not a speaker. This step you got?
Sir, I'm getting D.
No. You have to get this step.
Yeah, I got that.
From there we'll get Z bar equal to 1, right?
Yeah.
That means mod of Z is equal to 1. This is mod Z square equal to 1. So mod Z is 1. So mod Z equal to 1. And then I have used the condition that Z is not equal to 1. So this condition is required. Because here, just mod Z equal to 1, but that condition is not mentioned. Okay. So this is the right one. D. Okay.
Yes, sir.
This is the one where you have to manipulate from here to here. Actually, terms will cancel on both the sides. It's not difficult. It's very simple. This one.
Sir,
YX.
But can you show the working? Because I'm not sure.
No, you're following the steps, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So which step is not clear? See, z is mod z is equal to 100, so it's on a unit circle, and z is not equal to plus or minus 1, so there are two holes here. So theta cannot be 0 and pi. Okay. And z pi divided by 1 minus z square is this one. So this you can simplify. And this I can write as cos pi by 2 minus theta plus I sine pi by 2 minus theta I made a mistake here.
Yeah.
This is a minus sign, right? Minus sign, and then minus sign again absorb in cos theta minus pi by 2 plus I sine theta minus pi by 2. Yeah.
Hello, sir.
You're following the steps, no?
I cannot hear you.
No, just follow the steps. I think the audio has some problems there. So the top one is angle theta. And the bottom one is angle theta minus pi by 2. So both of them will combine.
Okay. Yeah, now.
Yeah. Angle pi by 2 on the top divided by 2 sine theta. So this is equal to I by sine theta. So this is a purely imaginary number, put it on the y-axis.
Okay.
See, he has given mod z equal to 1. Okay, so it is a circle of radius 1. Okay, and I said z is not equal to plus or minus 1. So there are two holes here, plus 1 and minus 1. Okay, holding that point is not there. Okay, so this complex number I can represent as e raised to I theta, the radius is 1. Okay, and theta not equal to 0 and pi because of these two holes. Okay, now I have to find the value of z divided by 1 minus z square. So z by 1 minus z square is, in terms of this notation, is e raised to I theta divided by 1 minus I2 theta. Okay, so this is cos theta. Numerator I can just keep it like that. This one is 1 minus cos 2 theta and then sine 2 theta. Is that right?
Yes.
And this 1 minus cos 2 theta I can write as 2 sine square theta. Okay. And this sine 2 theta is 2 times sine cos. So I can take 2 sine theta outside and become sine minus cos. Actually, this is the negative sign. Okay, so and this is what we have is cos plus I sine, right? So this I can rewrite as cos in terms of cos. Sine theta is cos pi by 2 minus theta, right?
Yeah.
Similarly, cos theta I can write like this. Okay, and this minus sign is there. So this minus sign can absorb inside. Sine theta minus pi by 2 is minus sine pi by 2 minus theta, right? Sine theta is sine minus theta is minus sine theta. Remember? Trigonometry?
Yes.
And cos minus theta is cos theta. Cos will absorb the minus sign, but sine will just throw out the minus sign. So this minus sign I'm taking inside and changing the angle. And cos theta is same as cos x is same as minus cos x, so I can just reverse the sign of the angle. It will not make any difference. Okay, so cos pi by 2 minus theta is same as cos theta minus pi by 2. Okay, but in the sign, the minus sign will get absorbed. So this is angle theta minus pi by 2, and the numerator is angle theta. Angle theta is this one, right? Denominator is angle theta minus pi by 2. So when I divide, the angle gets subtracted, so it will become pi by 2. Is it clear? Numerator, yes, angle, sir. Angle theta, denominator is angle theta minus pi by 2. R is 1 for both numerator and denominator. Only the angle is different. So that difference is pi by 2. Okay. And the denominator, we have this 2 sin theta, right? So that will come here. And angle pi by 2 is I.
Yeah.
Because it is this point. Right? So I by sin 2 theta. So it is on the y-axis. And theta not equal to 0 and pi is making sense here because the denominator should not go to 0. Sin theta is 0 at 0 and pi. That is, again, this is infinite. That's why they are given this condition. Okay. So these manipulations you have to be familiar with. Recognizing this as this one, and then taking this thing and then converting theta to pi by 2 minus theta, because I want this in this format, cos plus I sin, and this minus sign is there, so I am absorbing it, that sign in this angle. Okay. So 14 is D. Okay, revise after the class.
Yes, sir, I'll just download this.
You do your drive. Okay, equation of a circle. What is the equation of a circle in coordinate geometry? You know that or not? X square plus y square equal to r square, right?
No, sir, I don't know coordinate geometry.
Equation of a circle, you know?
No, sir. In coordinate geometry, I only know like basics, section formula, area of triangle, and distance formula.
Circles you have not done, right?
No, sir.
Okay, just assume.
I think it's in a line.
Yeah, just assume this is here. No, it will come in 11th standard. It is there. So it is x square plus y square plus 2fx plus 2gy plus c equal to 0. So this is equation of circle. F, g and c are numbers. The center of the circle is minus g comma minus f. Okay, and the radius is square root of g square plus f square minus c.
Okay.
This is the center of the circle. Okay, here they are saying z is a complex number, but mod z square is real, right? Okay.
Yeah.
And a is a complex number, z is a complex number, and a z bar conjugate is a bar z, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And if you add a complex and its conjugate, you will get real number.
Yeah.
Okay. A z bar is complex and a bar z is complex individually, but they are conjugates of each other. So when I combine these two, I'll get real number. And b is real. It's given. Okay. So this is the equation of a circle. To prove that, you have to put mod z is x plus i y. Z is x plus i y. So mod z is what? Mod z square is what? What is mod z square?
Hello.
You can hear me, right? And take this complex number A. A1 plus A2. A is a complex number, so take it as A plus IA2, and B is some real. So if you put these things in this equation, A is A1. Plus IA2, A1 and A2 are real. Z bar is X minus IY. Similarly, this term, B is real, equal to 0. And if you simplify this one, we'll finally get an expression. Okay, with the center of the circle will be minus A1 comma A2, minus A2. Okay, and radius right. A1 and A2 are real. These A1 and A2 are real numbers. A is complex. Okay. So if you simplify, manipulate these things and simplify, you will get equation in this form. Once you get equation in this form, you can find out what is center and radius using this formula.
Okay, sir.
Right. So, yeah. So you have to use this result to solve a problem. Okay. Find center and radius of all the points represented by z equal to satisfying the relation. Yeah. So this is the condition. Z is a complex number. Express IY. Okay, and Z is satisfying this condition. We have to show that Z lies on a circle. See, the condition is like Z minus Z naught, where Z naught is a constant number, equal to R. So what does this thing mean? Mod Z1 is Z0 equal to R. So what does this thing mean? This you know, right? This means that Z lies on this circle of radius R. Z lies on this circle of radius R. Of radius R, and the center of the circle is at Z naught. Is it clear?
Yeah.
That is the meaning of this one. Okay. Similarly, here the condition for Z is this one. It is given as this one. So, using this condition, we have to show that Z lies on a circle. Just 2 marks. So how do you do it? So this you can rewrite as this one, right? Okay, we just square it and mod z square you can write as z is z conjugate. Is it clear? Mod z square can be written as z conjugate. Yeah, you can see the screen, right?
Yes.
Okay. So this is the condition we are given. And then we have to show that z lies on a circle where z is x plus i y. That's also given. Okay. So using this condition, we'll start. So this means that this is true, right? If I square it, I'll get k square. Right? And mod z square can be written as z into z conjugate. So this square can be written as that complex number into its conjugate.
Yeah.
Right? And similarly, this square can be written as that into that conjugate. Okay, now we can open the brackets and simplify. Okay, so we'll get this one. Then look at it briefly. There'll be z into z bar, there'll be mod z square. And then z will be there, z bar will be there. Similarly on the right side, mod z square, z bar, z, and then mod beta square. Okay, it's beta into beta conjugate. Okay, so this you can bring terms of mod z square, z bar, z, and then the constant. So this you can rewrite as this one. Mod z square and then z bar, z, this one. So and equation of a circle is this one. So if you compare these two,
yeah,
these two, you will say this equation of a circle, where A is this combination, and A complement is obviously A conjugate is this one because this and this are conjugates. And then B is this one. Okay, so we are using this result here. The equation of a circle is mod z square plus a z bar plus a bar z plus b, where z is a complex number x plus iy, and a and b are constants, but a is a complex number and b is a real number. So full center is a and radius is this one. So this whole thing is a result which you are using here. So for this, you get center as this one. And radius as this one, which can be simplified and got as this one. Okay. And why is this thing a circle? That's what we are trying to do here. Just put these things and simplify, you will get in this form, this final thing. From this, you can see what is G and F. So G will be A1, F will be A2. So that's why center is minus A, minus 3. And radius I can simplify and get like this. So this is a result which you are using here. So the answer for this one is this one. Okay. So I'll put this thing in your notes, you just check it. Okay, you have sent one question in WhatsApp, log question.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Okay, put this thing equal to k. Okay, and then write the numerator as k into the denominator. Okay, and take k to the power. I'll just write it here. You can see the screen, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Log to base B of whatever quantity equal to K into log A to base B. Is this clear? I have to find K.
Yeah.
Okay. So this and this K, I can take it on top. I mean, log of A raised to the power K B. Is it correct?
Yes.
So this bracket should be equal to A raised to the power K.
Yeah.
So what is inside the bracket is log X to base B. Right. I'll find K, right? What are the options? The value of something I missed. A is for the whole thing. Okay, what I have to, what I have to find is A is for K. This is the question.
Yeah.
Okay. I just took in the power as k. What I have to find is a raised to the power k. So that is this one. Log x to base b. So answer is b. Okay.
Sir, can you repeat how you did?
No. Whatever is there in the power, that is this one. Log b divided by log b of something. See, what A raised to the power something, right? That I'll call as K.
Yeah.
So from there, I'll get this first step.
Log, okay.
From there, I'll get this first step. Okay. And this thing, yeah. I got. This step is clear?
Yeah.
So from this, this one.
Okay. Okay, sir, understood. Okay.
What you have to find is A is the power K.
Okay, sir.
Whenever log of some complication is there, put it as equal to something and take log on both the sides. Something like
okay, that. Okay, sir. Okay, sir, thank you.
Yeah, put it as K and then and then use log properties. So, if your internet connection, you're using the Wi-Fi, no?
Yes, sir. Actually, today only this problem happened because I was using one time only.
If more people are using, then it will not work properly.
Yeah.
Because the speed is getting shared, no?
Yeah.
Okay. So, this I'll put in the folder. I'll just revise it. Here I'll put. And I'm putting the date here, 9th June. So today's thing will be 11th June. Okay.
Okay.
So we should be, that should not be difficult to figure out. Right. And this Excel sheet, have you done anything? I'm doing 5B. Okay. Problems from here. Actually, there are a lot of problems. Complex number is taking out to be a bit more difficult than what I thought. Okay. So, have you tried anything from 1, 2, 3?
Sir, some questions randomly I tried.
Okay.
Sir, in that coaching, we are going to do sequence and series after quadratic equation.
Okay. Uh-huh. Right. That's not okay. That will basically have AP and GP finally.
Yeah.
And arithmetic mean geometric mean. Okay, I think Alan also has forming a particular sequence. That's why the determinants are coming here, right? So
sir, what chapter we are going to talk about complex number?
Hold on. See, these people have put numbers like a 0, 1, 0, 2 like that. So first what see first what they are doing is relation, that is the sets and then area under the curve, binomial. So they have covered determinants first. But
okay.
So that's why when they do complex numbers, it's not a problem for them. But I think I should have followed this sequence. Determinant they have done, and then infinite regression limit logarithms they have done, and then permutation combination. Okay, circle. Okay, so before complex number circle is being done. That's why it's not a problem. I'm following the NCRT sequence. That's why it's flashing.
So in NCRT, what is after this chapter?
What is after complex numbers? Inequalities.
Inequalities.
That's not a
okay.
That's not a difficult thing.
That is easy. Like
that's not a
we have done that already.
Yeah. Otherwise, I'll try to do one thing. I'll follow this sequence from now on. Because
follow which sequence?
This sequence. Allen sequence.
Allen.
Only then it will be easy for me to solve problems.
Yeah.
Because here the determinant is covered before. So complex number is coming later. So if you follow this sequence, it will be easy for me.
Okay, sir. So which chapter we are going to do?
This is done. Sets. Sets relations. Area under the curve. Binomial theorem. These two. Area under the curve is not a big thing. But if there are problems which are complicated, it might take time. Binomial theorem I can do. So I'll try to do this one.
Okay, sir.
Okay, then. See you tomorrow.